Have you heard of quantum computing? Have you read any news articles about it lately? You see, everyone is talking about AI. That's not just a feeling, it's a fact. If you check Google Trends, you can clearly see the spike in Google searches for AI after ChatGPT was launched November 30th, 2022. But before AI became the shiny new object, for many tech journalists, quantum computing was supposed to be the technology that would revolutionize the world. But if quantum computing seemingly has been placed on the back burner, does that mean it's a failed technology? Or are we not seeing the big picture? Let's find out more about what quantum computing is and if it will be relevant in the future. How about we let Gemini, Google's experimental conversational AI service, answer the question, what is quantum computing? At the heart of quantum computing lies the concept of qubits, the quantum counterparts of classical bits. While classical bits can only exist in one state at a time, either 0 or 1, qubits can exist in a superposition of both states simultaneously. Wow. I feel intelligent reading that. But what does it actually mean? Let's dig a bit deeper. A classical bit is the smallest unit of data that a computer can process and store. A bit is always in one of two physical states, similar to an on-off light switch. The state is represented by a single binary value, such as a 0 or 1. A qubit or quantum bit is the quantum mechanical equivalent of a classical bit. Just like a classical bit, a qubit can represent a 0 or 1. But it also can represent any proportion of 0 and 1 in superposition of both states, with a certain probability of being a 0 and a certain probability of being a 1. Superposition allows quantum algorithms to process information in a fraction of the time it would take even the fastest classical systems to solve certain problems. Let's put that into perspective with a simple example. A classical 64-bit computer can process 8 bytes of information in each computation step. In contrast, a 64-qubit quantum computer can process 36 billion billion bytes of information in each step of computation. Here's a simplified analogy to illustrate the power of quantum computing. Imagine you're trying to find a specific person in a crowded stadium. With a classical computer, you would have to search each person one by one. But with a quantum computer, you could use superposition to search for all the people in the stadium simultaneously, greatly reducing the time it takes to find the person you're looking for. Okay, so we understand what a qubit is and why it's superior to a bit. But Gemini has more to say about what makes quantum computing so different from classical computers. Another key concept in quantum computing is entanglement. When two or more qubits are entangled, they become linked in such a way that they cannot be described independently. Entanglement allows quantum computers to perform calculations with unprecedented precision and efficiency. Let's have a look at a simplified example of what entanglement is. Imagine two entangled coins. When you flip one coin, it instantly determines the state of the other coin, even if they are separated by a large distance. This is because the two coins are linked together in a way that we don't fully understand yet. Mind-bending, right? There are three main advantages quantum computing has compared to classical computing. Quantum computers can solve certain types of problems exponentially faster than classical computers. This is because they can perform computations on multiple values simultaneously thanks to superposition. Quantum computers can perform calculations with unprecedented precision thanks to entanglement. This is because entangled qubits can be linked together in such a way that they share the same fate. Quantum computers can be used to develop entirely new algorithms that are not possible on classical computers. This opens up a whole new realm of possibilities for computation. As we have seen, quantum computing is so much more powerful than classical computing. So surely it must be heavily used given its superiority. Well, quantum computing is still in its early stages of development. So if you're looking to buy yourself a quantum computer, you're going to have to wait a long time. And most likely, such computers will never be made available to mere mortals like you and me. At the forefront of quantum computing is IBM, followed by Google Quantum AI, Microsoft, Amazon, and more. These tech companies are working on improving their quantum computing systems and on proving that it is a useful technology that can be widely adopted. For example, IBM is working with Mercedes-Benz, ExxonMobil, CERN, and Mitsubishi Chemical to implement quantum computing into their products and services. The IBM and Mercedes-Benz case study shows how quantum computing can potentially help create better batteries for electric cars. Simulating what happens inside batteries is extremely difficult, even with the most advanced computers today. However, using quantum computing technology, Mercedes-Benz can more accurately simulate the chemical reactions in car batteries. Although quantum computing isn't mainstream today, hopes are high that one day, in the future, it will be useful for many vital tasks like the following. Quantum computers could be used to simulate molecular interactions and identify new drug candidates. Quantum computers could be used to design new materials with improved properties, such as superconductors and semiconductors. Quantum computers could be used to optimize financial models and make more informed investment decisions. Due to its enhanced speed and efficiency, quantum computing could help improve artificial intelligence. But it also could inspire new approaches to AI development, leading to the creation of more powerful and intelligent AI systems than we have today. Quantum computers could be used to break current encryption algorithms. In the director's cut of this video, I talk about the challenges in general and a big risk quantum computing poses for us all. Do you want access to the director's cut? Then head over to saperis.io/saperista where you will find out how you can get access to this exclusive content. At the beginning of this video, I asked if quantum technology was a failed technology since it's not nearly mentioned as much as artificial intelligence. My opinion is, quantum computing is not a failed technology. Instead, it is still in its early stages of development and it has the potential to transform our lives. But having the potential to do something and actually doing it are two very different things. So time will tell if quantum technology will live up to its potential. Can I ask you for a favor? If you've liked this video, then please hit the like button. I highly recommend you subscribe to this YouTube channel to learn more about technology.